I've got a serious question for you. If the Hamas terrorists in Gaza were to start building Auschwitz-style ovens to burn Jews like the Nazis did, would the world still demand that Israel stop defending itself and attacking them? Of course. See, the official goals of Hamas already are the same as the Nazis: to kill every Jew. The Hamas charter says so 12 times. And yet the world demands Israel's army stands down. Hamas's financial and political benefactors, their bosses really, are the Ayatollahs of Iran. They're building a nuclear bomb explicitly to attack Israel. And yet the world not only permits this, it repeatedly warns Israel not to preemptively attack Iran. Earlier this month, Hamas's leaders confirmed yet again that every Jew in Israel, man or woman, adult or child, is a target for their terrorism. Here, listen to Hamas's official prayers just on Friday. عقيدتنا في قتالكم أننا سنبيدكم على بكرة أبيكم ولن نبقي منكم أحدا لأنكم ظلام الأرض وشذاذ الآفاق ومرتزقة الزمان بل مرتزقة كل زمان راجعوا التاريخ أيها الإخوة. Hamas aren't soldiers as an army. They're terrorists. They're murderers. They're like the Nazis, but without the official army part, really, without the running a country part. They just want the Holocaust part. The Hamas chant, from the river to the sea, is shorthand for eliminating every single Jew from all of Israel, as in from the Jordan River to the Mediterranean Sea, not just from the disputed West Bank, but from everywhere in Israel. Just as Hamas does not distinguish between civilians and soldiers, it does not distinguish between different proposed peace maps. They just want all the Jews dead. You can hear that chant even in English, even in Canada, at any anti-Israel, pro-Hamas rally you look at. From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free. That's the new Nazi chant. That's the new kill all the Jews chant. And you can hear it in English in Canada. And yet the world demands that Israel stop defending itself. Destroying the sole Jewish state is a different goal from creating a Palestinian state, which would be the 23rd Arab country in the world. Now, in 2005, Israel gave Palestinians at least part of a state, the Gaza Strip. Israel forcibly removed every Jew who lived there and handed Gaza over to the Palestinians. Israel even gifted 3,000 greenhouses that were owned by the Jews who used to live in Gaza. They gave them to the Palestinians as a ready-made industry. Now, it's unlikely that Gaza could have become an Arab Hong Kong or something, although stranger things have happened, as the Arab city of Dubai shows. But instead of setting to work building Gaza as a prosperous or even a peaceful mini-state, the Palestinians chose Sharia law and a terrorist government that has fired thousands of rockets at Israel from amongst Gaza's houses and schools. And those 3,000 greenhouses, yeah, like the Jews themselves, gifts from the Jews had to be destroyed, and they were. So back to my first question. If Hamas started building a little Auschwitz, a little concentration camp, with Jew-burning ovens in Gaza, would the world stand by and, worse, tell Israel to stop defending itself? The concentration camp ovens question, it's not hyperbole. I mean, Hamas has fired thousands of rockets at Israeli civilians. Some are unsophisticated mortars, but others are genuine military weapons imported from Iran. Now, it's miraculous that so few of these missiles have actually killed Jews. Israel has deployed an anti-missile defense system called Iron Dome that has shot down 90% of the rockets that were on course to hit populated areas. This too has earned the world's condemnation. How dare Jews not die, at least proportionately with their Hamas enemies? Just listen to the media party go on about the civilian death count being disproportionate.
There really is a sense that the Palestinians are bearing such a disproportionate amount of the casualties here.
The Palestinian death toll has surpassed 1,000. Israel has lost 40 soldiers and 2 civilians in the fighting.
51 people, mostly soldiers, the Palestinians report. More than 1,000 of their people have been killed, mostly civilians.
Again, mostly civilian. 32 Israeli soldiers and 3 civilians have also been killed,
raising the death toll in Gaza to more than 1,000.
But is that a ratio that's defensible?
A disproportionate death toll in that conflict.
230 Palestinian deaths, 1 Israeli.
Using disproportionate force.
The ratio between the number of Palestinians killed and the number of Israelis killed is 23 to 1. 695 Palestinians, 35, not 30, Evan, Israelis. But only three of the Israelis were in fact civilians, and only two of them were Israelis. One was a Thai worker.
Come on, you Jews, why don't you go to the slaughter like you're supposed to? Why don't you die like you're supposed to? Look, let's be honest, world opinion really doesn't give a damn when Arabs die. I hate to say it, they don't. I mean, this past week has been one of the deadliest weeks in the whole Syrian civil war. More than 700 Arabs killed in a week, but they were killed by other Arabs. That's about 150,000 Arabs killed in the Syrian civil war so far. Can you remember any big street protests? Thousands of people all across the world chanting for Syria to be free in our streets in Canada and streets across the West? Of course not. Not even fellow Arabs seem to give a damn when Arabs are killed, unless it's a Jew who killed them, even if it was in self-defense. But look, there's no Iron Dome system that can protect Israel, that can defeat underground tunnels. Now, Hamas has spent billions of dollars and diverted countless resources donated to Gaza to build homes and schools and hospitals. They diverted it to a network of underground attack tunnels to Israel. These are not little tunnels dug with a shovel. They are massive underground engineering projects, some 70 feet underground, made with steel-reinforced concrete, going hundreds of feet past the Gaza-Israel border underground towards Israeli towns. Their purpose is obvious: to provide secret entrances through which terrorists can emerge, slaughter Jews, kidnap more, and then steal them away in those same tunnels to be kept as hostages back in Gaza. Only through the ground invasion of Gaza did Israel discover these tunnels and terrifying paraphernalia in them, including counterfeit Israeli military uniforms, handcuffs, tranquilizers. Captured Hamas terrorists confirm the purpose: sneak attacks on Israeli towns timed for this fall. These tunnels were revealed before Barack Obama demanded Israel cease fire against Hamas. So I ask you the question again: if Hamas were to be caught building an Auschwitz, would the world still tell Israel to go quietly to the slaughter? And the answer again is, of course. Now, after the Holocaust, Western liberals came up with a slogan: never again. They swore that they would never again allow a second Holocaust. Well, it's been less than 70 years, and a second one is being promised and planned, and the new Nazis are trying to execute that plan. It is a second Holocaust, but is it possible? I mean, could it really happen? Well, it's even more possible than the first, because the first one was unimaginable. Now that the first Holocaust has happened, we can imagine it, and millions of these new Nazis can imagine it, and they dream about it, and they support it happening, and this time, it wouldn't take 6 years to do as Hitler took. It could take 6 seconds with an Iranian nuke. And the Nazis aren't just concentrated in one country as they were in Germany in the 30s and 40s. The Nazis are even here across the West and even here in Canada. I mean, Paris, France is burning as tens of thousands of these new Nazis, Muslim extremists from North Africa mainly, riot in the streets, harass individual Jews, and try to storm synagogues. And here in Canada too. Here's a very pretty young girl who works for the hydro company in Ontario, saying on Facebook that Hitler should have finished the job. She's so pretty, isn't she? She'd be for sure a poster girl for the Hitler Youth if this were Germany in the 1940s. She actually sent it directly to a Jew, although it's since spread widely. She's apparently trying to deny it now. And this guy, working for the Toronto Transit Commission, look.
Free Gaza, free Palestine, and if they continue now, from we will go from here there and we'll kill the Israel. We're going to kill that all Israel, and we're going to show the power what we can do further. Thank you.
You're going to kill Israel?
No,
you
want? No, I'm just saying we're going to go there and we're going to show the power to them.
I'm sure that's Nazism, except it has a foreign accent, and it's Muslim now. And so Western liberals are afraid to call it Nazism because we want to be politically correct and tolerant. If only there were a Jewish state in the 1930s with a tough and modern army as Israel has now, maybe they would have gone in and defeated the Hamas of the 1930s, the Nazi party. Maybe they could have stopped the Second World War from happening. Israel wants to stop Hamas from setting the world on fire in 2014, but most of the world, or at least the world's leaders, well, they don't seem to mind if the world burns a little bit. I guess they imagine, as with the Nazis, that maybe it'll just be the Jews who are burned. But no, if Hamas wins, if Al-Qaeda wins, if ISIS wins, if Iran wins, do you really think they'll limit their new Nazi wars to just the Jews? Say, if you're in Calgary tomorrow afternoon, come to my anti-Nazi rally, my pro-Israel rally, my pro-Canada rally. It's at 6 p.m. on the steps of Calgary City Hall. You can learn more at calgaryforisrael.ca. It's for every Canadian who supports democracies and opposes terrorism. And just as important, for those who are concerned that our Canadian police are turning a blind eye to this new Nazi violence on our streets, if you're in Calgary, I hope to see you tomorrow at 6. More Source after the break.